HBO's The Undoing is a story adapted from Jean Hanff Korelitz's book, You Should Have Known. And you should know that there will be spoilers in this video.
None of us are doing grapes.
Is.
I'm sorry?
Pardon? None of us is doing great. None is a contraction of not one. It's singular.
Here are 8 things that you may have missed or not have known. Number 1. Winter. Early in episode 1, we heard a piece of the first movement in Vivaldi's The Four Seasons Concerto 4 in F minor, Winter. And the episode also ended with more from this masterpiece. It's currently my second favorite song, and check out the comment that the College Cinderella left. Sometimes, classical music goes hard. This is one of those situations. Very nice. Number 2, the opening scene. So, you may have caught this, but I did not. We find out towards the end of episode 1 that Elena is dead. And that came as a shock to me, but it should not have, because the very first scene of the show revealed Elena's death. Apparently my memory fades even quicker than I previously thought. Number 3, the blender.
Could you just turn that down a bit, please? I'm trying to concentrate on a very delicate operation here.
The first time through the show, that seemed like a cute little interaction between a father and a son. But knowing what we know now, how Jonathan is a narcissist, how everything revolves around him, this scene definitely takes on new meaning.
Blenders don't have volume control.
Well, that's a pathetic excuse. Just turn it down anyway.
Number 4, the early giveaway. In a whodunit story, there tend to be very early clues, which is why it's always beneficial to be extra attentive and to put on your detective hat when watching show premieres or when reading the early chapters of whodunit books. Check out this line here, which is less than 8 minutes into episode 1.
I'm not blaming you, I'm just saying there's a particular type of person that you want to be with, and maybe you're a little too quick to see that person in the men that you meet, instead of seeing what's actually there.
Oh, the irony. Number 5. Irresistible urges. As you now know, Jonathan had an extramarital relationship with Elena. In this scene here, Grace talked about Elena standing there naked in front of her in the locker room, and this was his response.
Weird.
Good weird? Were you a little bit aroused?
This dude has no self-control. Number 6, the false narrator. I did not realize this until I read the books, but visions such as these, with Grace imagining Jonathan, they aren't real. They are not flashbacks. They are fantasies. Every time you see one of these visions, what it actually represents is Grace imagining the man whom she wants Jonathan to be, as opposed to the man who he really is. That's something that's happened since the day they met. And ironically, it's the very thing which she so often counsels her clients.
Instead of seeing what's actually there.
Number 7, misdirection. The school texted parents that there was a family tragedy, but Grace did not know the truth until her friend and gossip girl, Sylvia Steinitz, told her that Elena was murdered. Sylvia said this to Grace.
They're looking for the husband. They are. Evidently, they were having problems. It's always the husband.
Lo and behold, it was the husband, just not the one Sylvia was thinking of. And last but not least, number 8, good cop, bad cop.
I'm Detective Paul O'Rourke, 23rd Precinct.
Did you know that this actor here, Michael Devine, he played Detective Paul O'Rourke in the show, and he is a former NYPD Blue, a former officer playing one on HBO. Pretty cool. So all of this was from episode 1. Check out this playlist here for all the other The Undoing videos.